This panel enables you to view this. This panel is used to research new technologies that will enable your nation to gain advantage over its rivals. To begin, simply select the item you wish to research. The presence of a gentleman or scholar will speed up the process.
Awaiting further orders. Lord. Forward for crown and country.
A very large army or navy spread over two or more.
We rule the waves!
Periodically, your government will issue missions for you to undertake. Although optional, it can be useful to do them in order to learn various aspects of gameplay. Your first mission has arrived. To begin, simply click on the relevant message box on the left. Click on the missions button in the bottom right of the screen to view details of active missions.
March! Forward for crown and country! You scurvy dogs! Haul away!
Note that agents cannot be recruited as a unit might be. They are automatically spawned. In the case of gentlemen and scholars, the rate of this spawning is dependent on the level of the educational buildings, such as universities, within your empire. For rake, obedience to the system of government within a nation is measured in public order. If unhappiness, this panel gives you important information about a particular unit type. Number of men, recruitment and upkeep costs, experience, statistics, special abilities, and a detailed description.
fleet is lost!
There has been an eruption of national pride in your home region following your victories on the field of battle. Every time a battle is won, or... Right-click to move your army to any part of the Right-click to move your fleet to any part of the highlighted area. Move the fleet to a coast and right-click on land to disembark any passengers. Alternatively, select the units or agents you wish to disembark and right-click on the shore.
Make ready! Any further orders?
In order to gain control of a garrisoned and fortified city, it's often necessary to lay siege. During a siege, your troops surround the city, either attempting to starve the defenders into capitulation or launching a heavy artillery assault.
Men! Forward!
This panel gives information about how a building's effects work in the game, along with a detailed description of its function. Some buildings allow you to construct other, more advanced ones, so it's worth reading all the information here and checking the building browser.
Prepare the troops for battle.
Your army has successfully occupied a port belonging to the enemy. While the siege lasts, their food supply will be affected. Trade cannot pass through it, and no ships can be constructed there. Colonial plantations provide tradable goods for shipping back to your home region, the quantity of which is dependent on the type of plantation and its building level. Spices, tobacco, tea, cotton, coffee, and sugar can all be grown from plantations.
Approaching.
radar map allows you an aerial view of the battlefield, detailing the position of units. Use the plus and minus buttons to zoom in or out. You can grab the map and move it around by mousing over it, holding the left mouse button down, then moving the mouse around. The special abilities buttons are found in the bottom right corner of the screen. These turn on any special formations or abilities a selected unit has available to it. The button is disabled for those units without specialist skills. Flashing unit banner means the morale of their troops is wavering. Before long, they'll break from combat and crouch from the field. Take this opportunity to charge their ranks with you. It is important to preserve the devastating impact a cavalry unit can have. When going into combat with cavalry, always charge the last few yards by double right-clicking on the target. Beware of charging across too great a distance, though. It's a tiring business.
fleet ahead! Victory is ours! We are victorious!
There is unused land suitable for farming in this region. Building farms here will help the population to grow over time and produce trade income.
Forward! For crown and country! The swine rot.
When attacking a fort or city, a general can demand that, following capture of a capital city, it is important to leave an adequate garrison behind to quell unrest until both the population level and any damaged buildings are fully restored. Exempting the region from tax may also be helpful in the short term. Planning your construction needs is essential to a successful empire. Buildings of education further the research and acquisition of new technology.
Thank you.
The ruling classes have written a letter of demands to your national leader, as they are unhappy with the current government. Failure to comply will lead to an organized rebellion against you. Acquiescence at this stage could lead to further demands. Where exactly will you draw the line? The overall happiness of a population is split between the ruling class and lower orders, with different factors contributing to the happiness level of each. Rebellion becomes a risk when part of the population is so unhappy that state repression can no longer contain public disorder. Always try to ensure that public order values remain positive.
Underway, gathering supplies.
We can't do that, sir.
Orders, Captain. Weigh anchor.
Do not concentrate the construction of military buildings within a single region. Spread out to ensure the availability of troops during an invasion.
Make ready! Under sail!
Upgrading the road system within a region will increase its trade capability. Better quality roads also allow armies to march further within a turn.